white supremacist. This is what a former Breitbart news editor is calling Trump senior policy advisor Stephen Miller. It's a stunning thing to say. She knows him. I mean, how does she know he's a white supremacist? Well, you need to see this special report from our Sarah Seidner to find out.
Former Breitbart news editor Katie McHugh says she is doing her first television interview for one reason. She wants to expose a white supremacist in the White House.
You think Stephen Miller is a white nationalist?
A white supremacist, I would say, because I believe his ideology is one of domination and control over people of color.
You gotta take a couple questions.
Stephen Miller is a senior aide to President Donald Trump. He did not respond to our request for comment. A White House spokesperson has said that Miller is not a racist and is being attacked because he's Jewish. McHugh says that's laughable. She says on his rise to the White House while working for Senator Jeff Sessions,
are you ready to send Donald J. Trump to the White House?
And later on Trump's campaign, Miller was in constant contact with her, pushing stories that fit an anti-immigration narrative. Stories she wrote for Breitbart without question.
Were you a white nationalist?
I think I would call myself that. Whatever you want to call it, white nationalist, white supremacist, that's fine.
That's what you were?
Yes, but that part is dead.
Do you think this was solely political to let his star rise because he could manipulate you? Or do you think he actually is a white supremacist?
I believe he wanted access to power because he is a white supremacist and wanted to impose those policies. Those emails are, you know, you can read his own words.
McHugh says these are some of his own words in emails to her. She saved 900 or so exchanges between Miller and Breitbart staffers from 2015 to 2016. In 2015, not long after a white supremacist slaughtered 9 black Americans praying inside their Charleston church, McHugh says Miller called and emailed not with sympathy for the victims, but instead a focus on changing the narrative to outrage over the removal of Confederate statues and retailers removing Confederate merchandise. Have you thought about going to Amazon and finding the commie flag and then doing a story on that? Yes, definitely, she replies. This is the story McHugh wrote.
Did he ever once mention that he was sorry that 9 African Americans were slaughtered while praying in a church?
Never. No, it never occurred to him, it seemed.
But McHugh says immigration was his favorite subject. In 2015, he also sent McHugh an email, subject line, for your Islam story. In it, a link to the conspiracy website InfoWars. The headline, Reverend Graham, we are under attack. Stop all immigration of Muslims to the U.S. A few months later,
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
In another email exchange, Miller suggests coverage of immigration and the Pope. You see the Pope saying we must, in effect, get rid of borders? Someone should point out the parallels to Camp of the Saints.
Vile, vile, disgusting, racist novel.
The Camp of the Saints is a book beloved by white supremacists. A Breitbart editor published the content Miller suggested.
This election is a referendum.
And just before Miller heads off to work for the Trump campaign in 2016, he touts what he saw as the danger of allowing hurricane victims from Mexico to come to the U.S. They will all get TPS. That's temporary protection status. That needs to be the weekend's big story. TPS is everything, he says, and sends McHugh an article on the dangers of TPS from a prominent white nationalist website.
Did he want you to parrot a white nationalist website?
Yes, he did. It was understood that Miller had editorial control over the political section of Breitbart News.
Well after Miller joined Trump's inner circle, the U.S. ended TPS status for several countries. McHugh is ashamed of her role in all of this. She was fired by Breitbart for an Islamophobic tweet, among other things the website said, including for being a liar.
In 2015, you said, another crusade would do a lot of good. Let's turn Mecca into a strip mall. Another tweet, the only way to strike a balance between vigilance, discrimination, and terror is to end Muslim migration.
That's a quote from Miller. That's a paraphrase of a conversation that we had.
This was the tweet that ended up you getting fired over. There would be no deadly terror attacks in the UK if Muslims did not live there. Did you believe all these hateful, racist, Islamophobic things that you were putting out there on your Twitter feed?
I did.
Why should people believe you're sincere?
Because I believe in publicly confessing your sins. And I also believe that, you know, working very hard to expose these networks that I was a part of and show how dangerous they are, how evil they are, and how many people they hurt.
She says Stephen Miller should do the same and resign. But so far, there is no indication that Stephen Miller is going to resign. And even though the White House didn't talk about this particular story and make a comment, they have supported him. Erin?
All right. Incredible story. Sarah Seidner, thank you.